here in the music department, and I'm delighted to welcome you all to this operetta showcase, featuring selections from the Viennese, French, Spanish zarzuela, and English traditions. Operetta is a form of light opera that includes spoken dialogue, songs, and dances. It differs from traditional opera in terms of its musical style, production length, and at face value, subject matter. In contrast to the dramatic content of many operas, operetta explores virtuosic vocal flair with playful plot lines where amusing characters traverse comedic twists and turns. This concert is a part of an international exchange between UNC Chapel Hill and the Conservatory Giuseppe Tartini in Trieste, Italy, featuring my good friend and colleague Maestro Romolo Jessi. I met Maestro Jessi through my work with the International Young Artists Program Summer Festival based in Tuscany. Please note his extensive artist biography in your program. It has been an honor and a pleasure to have Maestro Jessi with us this week, and our students have benefited from his vast expertise coaching the music in preparation for tonight's workshop performance. Maestro Jessi, a few words?
So many thanks for inviting me here. It was a very busy week, but it was an exciting week too. The young students are talented. They did the best of their, the best they could. They were very patient with me, and I'm very thankful for this. And operetta is something magic. It's French, British, Italian, Spanish, Viennese operetta, of course. I come from a land of borders. My hometown is near Slovenia, Croatia, Austria, not far from Germany. So we are very fond of operetta. And I hope to be able to transmit, to give these feelings to the American students and to let them and you remember this evening as something special. Thank you for coming.
Finally, let me also thank our departmental chairs, outgoing Dr. David Garcia and incoming Dr. Jocelyn Neal, along with our dedicated staff, El Fisea, Elliot Chandler, Kat, Zachary, Jesse Moorfield, and our tech person tonight, Jesse Ainsley, for supporting this project and facilitating all the necessary steps to create this international exchange. One other item, let's all be sure that we silence any devices, and then now you can sit back and enjoy the show. As we begin, the aria Amour divin, ardente flamme, Love Affairs Divine, Burning Fire, is from the 1864 comedy La Belle Hélène, The Beautiful Helen, with music by Jacques Offenbach and libretto by Henri Meillac and Ludovic Olivier. Meillac was a famous French dramatist and opera librettist, best known for his collaborations with Georges Bizet and Jules Massenet, as well as the works of Offenbach. By 1864, Offenbach was well established as the leading French composer of operetta. After many successes with his early works, Offenbach was granted a license in 1858 to stage full-length operas with a large cast and full chorus. The Paris premiere of La Belle Hélène in 1864 was well received, with the productions following on three continents, and it continues to be revived today. The plot parodies the story of Helen's elopement with Prince Paris of Troy, which sets off the Trojan War. At the beginning of Act One, the beautiful Queen Helen of Sparta makes her first appearance at a ceremony at the Temple of Jupiter with the weeping servants of Adonis. She scoffs and complains about their mournful state of no love, no passion, setting the stage for her fatal predestined encounter with Prince Paris of Troy. Is from the 1905 operetta Die lustige Witwe, The Merry Widow, by Austro-Hungarian composer Franz Lehár, mainly known for his operettas, with libretto by Victor Leon and Leo Stein. The librettist adapted the story of a rich widow being pursued by many suitors for her hand in marriage to access her fortune, coming from the 1861 comedic play L'attaché d'ambassade, The Embassy Attaché, by Henri Meillac. This operetta continues to enjoy extraordinary international success since its 1905 premiere in Vienna, and is frequently revived and recorded, along with many film adaptations. At the beginning of Act Two, at a garden party, the character Hannah entertains the guests by singing an old love song describing how a woodland maiden meets a handsome hunter. Es lebt eine Vilja, ein Waldmägdelein. There lived a Vilja, a maid of the woods. While Hannah enthralls everyone with her song, the suitors are secretly scheming to win her hand in marriage. Sir William Schwenk Gilbert and composer Sir Arthur Seymour Sullivan. They jointly created 14 comic operas between 1871 and 1896, of which HMS Pinafore, The Pirates of Penzance, and The Mikado are among the best known. Gilbert wrote the libretti for these operas and created fanciful, topsy-turvy worlds where absurdity is taken to its logical conclusion. Sullivan composed the music and contributed memorable melodies that could convey both humor and pathos. Their operas have enjoyed broad and enduring international success and are still performed frequently throughout the English-speaking world. These operas have directly impacted the development of musical theater through the 20th century, influencing political discourse, literature, film, television, and are widely parodied by humorists. The producer, Richard Dolly-Cart, brought Gilbert and Sullivan together and nurtured their collaboration. He built the Savoy Theater in 1881 to present their joint works, known as the Savoy Operas, and founded the Dolly-Cart Opera Company, which performed and produced Gilbert and Sullivan's works for over a century. The Pirates of Penzance debuted in 1880 at the Opéra Comique in London and was extremely successful, running for 363 performances. The story concerns Frederick and his release from a band of tender-hearted pirates upon his 21st birthday. He meets the daughters of Major General Stanley, including the fair Mabel, and the two fall instantly in love. However, Frederick soon learns that he was born on the 29th of February, where, technically, he has a birthday only once each leap year. His indenture specifies that he remains apprenticed to the pirates until his 21st birthday, meaning he must serve for another 63 years. Bound by his own sense of duty, Frederick's only solace is that Mabel agrees to wait for him faithfully. You will hear Frederick's entrance aria and Mabel's response aria back to back.
Ever play you be alone.
Victor Herbert. Known as an American master composer, Herbert was a cellist and a conductor of English and Irish ancestry and German training. In addition to successful careers as both a cello soloist and conductor, Herbert is best known for composing many successful operettas that premiered on Broadway in New York from 1890 to 1914 at the start of World War I. He was prominent among the 10 Pan Alley composers, becoming a founding member of the performing rights organization American Society of Composers, Authors, and Publishers, or ASCAP. A prolific composer, Herbert produced 2 operas, 43 operettas, incidental music for 10 plays, 31 compositions for orchestra, 9 band compositions, 9 cello compositions, 5 violin compositions, and 22 piano compositions, as well as numerous songs and choral pieces. The Naughty Marietta had its first performance in 1910 in Syracuse, New York, and opened on Broadway later that same year, playing for 136 performances at the New York Theater. A film version of The Naughty Marietta was released by MGM in 1935, and a television version was broadcast live in 1955. Set in New Orleans in 1780, the story tells how Captain Richard Warrington is commissioned to unmask and capture a notorious French pirate known as Bras Pique. With the help of a high-spirited runaway, Contessa Marietta, the Italian Street Song is a famous coloratura aria for soprano occurring late in Act One, where the heroine disguises herself as an Italian nobleman's son and sings about Naples for the people of New Orleans.
Oh,
To a German libretto by Karl Hafner and Richard Genet, premiering in 1874 in Vienna. Johann Strauss was an Austrian composer of dance music and operettas, as well as a violinist. He composed over 500 waltzes and polkas, as well as several operettas and a ballet. In his lifetime, he was known as the Waltz King and was largely responsible for the popularity of the waltz in Vienna during the 19th century. In the story, Dr. Falke plans revenge on his buddy Eisenstein for playing a practical joke on him, which earned Falke the name Dr. Bat. Eisenstein's wife, Rosalinda, is being serenaded by an old flame named Alfred, and her chambermaid, Adele, asks for the night off to go partying. Eisenstein accepts Falke's invitation to a grand ball hosted by Prince Orlovsky, where the guests are served bottomless flutes of champagne. Eisenstein's wife, Rosalinda, also attends the ball disguised as a masked Hungarian countess with hopes of exposing her husband's advances towards Adele. In disguise, Rosalinda sings a csárdás, a traditional Hungarian dance, which begins with a slow introduction and ends with a fast, lively flourish. As the story ends, all the hilarious mayhem is sorted out, practical jokes are avenged, and all indiscretions are blamed on the champagne.
Thank you.
Is a Spanish zarzuela in three acts with libretto by Ricardo González del Toro and Fernando Luque, with music by Federico Moren Torroba, premiering in Madrid at the Zarzuela Theater in 1928. Torroba was a prominent composer of zarzuelas, conductor, theatrical impresario, and is remembered for his important contributions to the classical guitar repertoire, known as one of the leading 20th century composers for that instrument. Set in the revolutionary turmoil of 1840s Andalusia, the plot of La Machinera is a complex web of elopements, duels, and secret intrigues. Valentina, daughter of the Count of Hinojares, has fallen in love with an unworthy philanderer. In her petanera, a popular flamenco song style of the region, she equates her feelings of love to the wonder of the first spring rose, happy to die next to the heart of her beloved. Please welcome to the stage my voice faculty colleague, Jeannie Fisher, and pianist Maria Paulina Garcia.
Oh.
dell'Ovido, the Song of Oblivion, is a zarzuela in one act with a libretto by Federico Romero Saracaga and Guillermo Fernandez Shaw Iturralde, and music by José Serrano. It premiered with great success at the Teatro Lirico in Valencia in 1916. Serrano was a Spanish composer known for over 50 zarzuelas, heavily influenced by Italian Verismo opera. He composed the anthem of the Valencian Regional Exhibition of 1909, which has been officially adopted as the anthem of the Valencian community. The story takes place in the imaginary village of Sorrentinos in Naples, around the year 1799. In a square stands the Osteria del Ganso, where Princess Rosina lives with her faithful maid. Toribio, a traveling musician, arrives and he comments with the innkeeper about the courtesan Flora, who drives Captain Leonello, a handsome military man, crazy. Princess Rosina arrives with her maid and they enter the inn. Once settled in their room, they discuss the captain's scandalous affairs. Captain Leonello then appears with his entourage and devises a plan to seduce Flora, adding her to his long list of conquests. Rosina hears everything through the open window in her room and decides to hatch a plan to win her love. Captain Leonello tells Toribio to sing a serenade to Flora, but Rosina begins singing a song for Toribio from behind the latticework of her window, leaving Captain Leonello fascinated and intrigued by the mystery voice. With music by Jeronimo Jimenez and Manuel Nieto. It premiered in Madrid at the Teatro de la Zarzuela in 1901. Jimenez was a child prodigy who, at the age of 12, joined the Teatro Principal de Cádiz as first violinist, and by the age of 17 became director of an opera and zarzuela company. After completing his training at the Paris Conservatory, Jimenez mainly dedicated himself to the composition of zarzuelas, leaving a lasting legacy for the genre. Interestingly, Jimenez's El Barbero de Sevilla has nothing to do with Rossini's opera, but everything to do with backstage antics surrounding a provincial production of this famous masterpiece. Elena wants to be a singer despite her father's objections. Her mother and music teacher take advantage of the impresario's absence to thrust Elena into the limelight as Rosina in a pickup production of the Rossini opera. As a vocal warm-up before going on stage as Rosina, Elena sings the ever-popular and rhapsodic Me llaman la prima rosa, they call me the exquisite one.
Thank you.
In closing, we return to Vienna for Deines mein ganzes Herz. All of my heart is yours, from the 1929 operetta Das Land des Lächelns, The Land of Smiles, also by the composer Franz Lehár, with libretto by Fritz Nürnberg and Ludwig Herze. This love story takes place in Vienna, where Countess Lisa marries Chinese Prince Su Cheng, returning with him to his homeland despite the warnings of her friends and family. In Beijing, Lisa finds she is unable to embrace the ancient cultural traditions of the court, and in his aria, Su Cheng declares his deep devotion to their union. Unfortunately, her love fades and Lisa returns to Vienna, leaving Su Cheng all alone. Although their ending is sad, the prince respects the rule of his custom, always stay positive and smile. Although I had originally planned to sing this for you this evening, unfortunately I have some fall allergies that have invaded my larynx. But that being said, I do have a video performance on my YouTube channel that I invite you to enjoy. for coming.